Say a few words, get into the business of the meeting here. I think that 1986 is a year of opportunity, and it's a year when we can maintain and must maintain control of the Senate, and I think it's a year in which, contrary to history, we could, if we play our cards right, pick up additional seats in the House. We have a lot of challenges on both the foreign and domestic fronts, but I believe that we work together to show the American people that this Republican leadership team continues to produce positive results. Our economy continues to grow and our alliances around the world are stronger than ever. And I know we've bobbled a few times, we've compared the odds, and certainly the press have capitalized that to a great extent. And let's try and not try to do any of that, because I think what we have to prove to the American people is that the Republican Party can govern, and can govern better than the people that have been in charge basically for the last 50 years. Now, in a few weeks, I'll be sending the budget for fiscal year 87 up, and it'll meet the requirements of the Graham-Rudman-Hollins Act. It'll meet the target of the $144 billion deficit, but it will not raise taxes, and it will not hurt the aged and needy, and it won't cut into the ability of our nation's defenses to protect our national security. I've heard some voices saying the deficit couldn't be reduced unless taxes go up and defense spending goes down. I believe with all my heart they're absolutely wrong, and I think we have an opportunity to prove that they're wrong. Regarding another budget matter, I want you all to know I support reconciliation. However, I'm disturbed by many provisions, including the reconciliation bill last year. In its present form, the bill is unacceptable, and we've stated this many times. It should be a means to make savings, not to slip policy changes into law, which couldn't survive the normal legislative process on their own, and not to add funding when we have a $200 billion deficit. Now, I'm going to ask Jim Miller to discuss where we stand on the budget and the reconciliation in a little bit more detail.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let me describe briefly our implementation of the 1986 sequester, and then I'll go into the budget and reconciliation.
Reagan?
Jim Robinson.
Yes, Chairman Jim. Hi, how are you?
Good to see you again.
Nice to see you.
This is great.
Okay, you don't know what you just have to say.
But I'm looking forward to it.
You will.
Well, Mr. President, that represents last year's effort by United Way. We raised $2.333 billion, and that was up just under 10%. And I think the impressive thing, as we see it over the last 3 years, is that we've been able to increase our annual contributions a total of 31%, and that's in an environment of only about 12% inflation. So there's substantial real growth in there, and we're proud of it.
Well, my gosh, yes. Well, congratulations. I think it's just great. You're pretty instrumental in making it happen, sir. The climate you've created for the country has been absolutely central to our achieving this objective, and you and Nancy have been absolutely fantastic for us. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, congratulations, though.
Well, it's as I like to say, it's a great backswing. Now let's see what the follow-through looks like, because it's just the beginning. And the second reason we're here today is to thank you for agreeing, both of you, to be chairpeople of our Centennial Committee, because in 1987, United Way will be 100 years old. And that's 100 years of people caring for people. It's 100 years of volunteerism. And you know, both of you know United Way as well as anybody in this room or town for that matter, because I know how long you've both supported it and been active. In fact, I've got a picture here from,
great picture. These are great.
From 1960 of you when you were national spokesperson for United Way with Danny Thomas.
Oh.
And,
is that Bill Holden?
No.
That's Gordon McRae.
Gordon McRae.
And what I don't understand is how you don't look any older today than you did.
Jim, I was just going to say I was never that young. Well, we want to put our thank you in writing, so
well,
a letter of acceptance.
That's wonderful, and I understand that with this you've issued a little bit of a challenge, and that's to help this country kind of resurvey what its needs are, community by community, and we've got just that effort underway. And Dick Ferris is chairing our centennial effort, and together with Bill Aramone and all those volunteers out there, we're going to be working hard at doing just that. And we set a goal of doubling everything that we're doing over the next 5 years. And I know you endorse that. In fact, tell us to get on about it and do it soon.
Thank you very much.
That's
we have a little something for you, Jimmy. You want to?
Right, this is in case you misplaced your.
Here, hold that for you, Jim.
In case you misplaced your advance to the United States.
Thank you.
Mr. President, we've also got a, this says volunteer, it should say chief volunteer.
Absolutely.
Well, all right.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Thank you very much. You've been great. Really appreciate it.
Oh, good.
Right.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's right.
We've raised a little over 4.5 million.
That's what I hear. That's great. Didn't you be over?
Wouldn't it be nice if it...
This is just January. If we keep working all year long, we'll get a lot more community.
I was just going to say, wouldn't it be nice if the government's charitable efforts could run with the same level of overhead that the
right.
That's
true.
That sounds like a great theme for the State of the Union.
Voluntary sector.
Isn't that a good idea?
All right, we will see you this evening.
All right.
Look forward to it.
Thanks so much for your time.
And
for
good to see you.
I should have gotten those pictures. I don't understand. I wonder where they were sent.
Check back.
They've got some other ones, too, that you're going to love.
We have some great shots of you, as well as the president.
Oh, really? Really
great. You were both volunteers back then.
Really?
Speaking of photos, Terry wanted to know if we could get one more photo of both.
Okay. But I remember the night where Justin was our house singing old songs.
Oh, my.
That was a long time ago.
Yes.
Thank you.
There you go.
There.
Well, that's a fantastic letter.
He has nipple put
there. Okay.
Well, that's a fantastic effort on your part.
Yeah, it's going to be a real challenge. You know, the great thing is that I got him to come on the United Way. So he became chairman. I'm chairman when I won't be in front of us for sure.
We'll need to prove it to get it so bent out of shape.
Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Well, welcome. Good to see you.
Let Jim come right on by me.
Nice to see you, sir. Delighted. Come on, Master. Good to see you, sir. How are you?
Before leaving Japan, I had a chance to meet Foreign Minister Abe. And Mr. Abe, I was here in Washington for the MOS talks, yes, for the four sectors between himself and Secretary Schultz. And yen dollar talks initiated by
I have one problem on my mind I would like to